So welcome back once again to my channel Osmosis. Today we will learn the second part of narration. This is the continuation of the first part. So here we will learn direct speech and indirect speech according to types of sentences. So conversion according to types of sentences. Now for types of sentences, I think you know that what are the types of sentences? Assertive, interrogative, imperative, exclamatory, optative. Now, just a very brief introduction to all these sentences. Assertive, any sentences, yes, no type. I go to school is an assertive sentence. I like you, it's an assertive sentence. I don't like you, that is an assertive sentence. Assertive sentence that has assertion as well as negation. So, negative is I do not like something. So that is, so assertive has two types. One is declarative, another is negative. Interrogative are again of two types. One is WS, one is yes no type. Whenever we get the answer in yes or no, it is yes no type. And if we get the answer in some sentences, that is WS. What is your name? My name is so and so. So that is WS. Do you like tea? Yes. So yes, no type. Imperative suggests, as I have already told you in voice change, order, request, command, proposal. These are imperative. Exclamatory. Exclamations. Hurrah, we have won the match. Alas, the boy died. Oops, I got stuck. Optative. Wish of mine. Hope. Could I be the Prime Minister of India is a hope. So that is optative. Optative may be of blessings also. May you live long. Curse also. May you go to hell. So these are optative sentences. Now let's come back to assertive sentences. Now assertive, as I have told you, any sentences, yes no type. So assertive, you don't have to be afraid of this. Everything same. Earlier rules we have learned all same. So I have given only two examples. So that's enough. The laborer said, I do not work on Sunday. How do you write that? The laborers said that he did not work on Sundays. The child said, I am very hungry, mother. The child said that he was said to his mother. Mother is there. So said to his mother that he was very hungry. So assertive, all the rules same as we have learned in part 1. Now, interrogative, as I have told you, yes no type and WS, two types are there. So in case of yes no type, how will you do? Rules are different and WS also rules are different. In yes no type, the teacher say, ask already there, is your father at home? So if ask is not there, say is there, then what will you use? Ask already, it is there in the question, so you will continue with that. If there is said, you can use ask, interrogated, etc. The teacher ask. Now, that you don't have to use in interrogative sentences. The teacher asks if or whether you can use. The teacher asks if or whether his father was at home. Understood? So in case of interrogative sentences, you don't use that. In place of that, you use if or whether in case of WS questions. If the answer you will get in yes or no, see whether you will get the answer in yes or no, or you have to answer fully. If it is yes no type, then you use if or whether. The rest of the rules same. Sohan said, may I use your pen, Mohan? Sohan ask whom, Mohan, if or whether he may will turn to might, because it is past tense. If he might use his pen. I ask Atul if he got up early every day. So here no place for answer. Here how do you write this? This is already in direct speech. Turn it into direct. I said Atul, do you if he got up early, do you get up early every day? Question mark, don't forget. Question mark will come at the end of indirect speech. Don't forget that. Now WS type. In case of WS type, the rules are little different. She asked me what my name was. She said to me, this is already in indirect speech. She said to me, what is your name? Have you noticed here? So if or whether is not used. What is used? WS word will remain in direct as well as direct speech. I said to my friend, how many brothers are you? I ask my friend. Two is not needed now. If you are using ask, I ask my friend, how many brothers are, will turn to where they. So pronouns you have to change according to the need of the sentences that you always take into your notice. I asked my friend, how many brothers were they? Mohan said to Sohan, what help can I give you? Can you try this? Mohan asked Sohan, what help could, can will turn to could I will be he, could he give him? You will be him because he is talking about Sohan. Mohan asked Sohan, what help could he give him? So at the end of indirect speech, question mark no need. So understood these two types, assertive, all rules same like all your rules we have learned in part one, conversion of direct into indirect, because assertion are only yes no type questions, yes no type sentences. And interrogative, two types, yes no type and WS. So in case of yes no type, you have to use if or whether. And in case of WS question, the WS word will retain or remain in indirect as well as direct speech. And at the end, we have to give question mark in direct speech, and in indirect speech, no need. And that you don't have to use. In place of that, you have to use after ask, you have to use if or whether, or in case of WS word. So that is not needed. Understood? Clear? In case of imperative sentences, Now, how to convert, how to transform from direct to indirect. Now, imperative sentences suggest, order, request, command, proposal, advice. So, mostly, even warn, forbid, these are also included in imperative sentences. So, in case of imperative sentences, in place of say, we will use order, request, command, proposal, warn, forbid, etc. according to the type of sentences. You have to see what is the type. The teacher said to the student, do not waste your time. So, what is this? Advice. Teacher can advise the students. So, in place of said, you will write advised. So, it's very easy. Only see the type of the sentences and use the word. The teacher advised the students not to waste their time. The teacher forbade Sheila to do like that. Forbid means to say no. The teacher said, do not do like that. Inverted comma will come. Don't forget the inverted commas and start with capital letters, as I have already taught you. The queen said to the maid, make my bed. What is it? It's an order. So, the queen ordered the maid to make her bed. Sheena said to me, let us go for a picnic. This is proposal. Sheena, let the sentences starts with let. Let us will be a proposal. Sheena proposed me to go for a picnic. Jawan said, march forward. Jawans, what does they give? They give order. Jawans, command. Jawans commanded to march forward. Santa said to Sheila, not to let him deceive her. Santa said to Sheila, let not him deceive you. So these are imperative sentences. What we have learned here? According to the type of sentences, you use order, request, command, proposal, propose, warn, forbid, etc. in place of say or said. Now let's come to exclamatory sentences. Exclamatory sentences exclaimed with sorrow, regret, or scold, or applaud, or confess, or beg. So according to the need of the sentences, we can use this in place of say. She said, what a beautiful flower it is. So, this is an exclamation of joy. So, she exclaimed with wonder also you can write. She exclaimed with joy that the flower is very beautiful. Flower is very beautiful. Understood? Suresh said, goodbye my friends. Suresh bade goodbye to his friends. She said, alas, my mother died. Alas is sorrow. She exclaimed in sorrow, with sorrow, that her mother died. He said, hurrah, we won. That is joy. He exclaimed with joy that they had won. Had won because both are in past tense. So we are using past perfect here. I have already told you earlier. He exclaimed with joy that they had won. They had won. Finish. The student said to the teacher, good morning, sir. What is it? Waste. The students wished the teacher good morning. The captain said, bravo, you have done my mates. Bravo is applaud, praise. So the captain applauded or praised his mates. Bravo, you have done. He said, how foolish I have been. He regretted that he had been very foolish. Pooh, what a dirty child, she said. Pooh is hatred. She exclaimed with hatred that the child is very dirty. So this is the way you used to do exclamatory sentences. Exclaim with sorrow, regret, scold, applaud, confession, bed, according to the need of the sentences.
So you have completed exclamatory sentences.
One more thing I forgot to say. So I made a mistake here. She exclaimed with joy that the flower was. It should be was, because here ease is there. So you have to write here was. Both you have to turn it into past. Some might have noticed it. So now let's move to optative. The last
in optative sentence.
Optative sentence suggests wish, curse or blessing. So we use wish, curse or blessing in place of say. The old man said to her son, may you live long. So this is a prayer. The old mother, this is not a prayer, blessing actually. The old mother blessed her son to live long. God save the king, save the people. Here, people are praying. The people prayed that God might save the king. Would I were rich, said the beggar. So beggar, it is a wish. The beggar is wishing. The beggar wished to be bridge. May you go to hell, the mother said to her son. This is a curse. The mother generally don't curse, but maybe she is very much offended. The mother cursed her son. That's enough. She wished that he might succeed in the test. She said, this is in indirect speech, so we are converting into direct. She said, may you succeed in the test. The dying man longed for a glass of water. The dying man said, oh for a glass of water. So this is the way how we used to do optative sentences, transformation from direct to indirect or indirect to direct. So we have completed your narration.